this video we will see the construction of LALR and CLR passing tables. They are slightly different from the SLR passing table in the sense that they are using canonical collection of LR1 items. So LR1 items are nothing but LR0 items plus look ahead. You know that an item is any production with a dot to the right hand side, but in case of LR1 items we will have one look ahead symbol, that is this one. In case of LR0 items there were no look ahead, that is why LR0, but in case of LR1 items there is a look ahead symbol. So we will see how do we find out the look ahead symbol. See, if a production is like S dash gives S dot S, and this is the augmented production, and we are adding a dot to the left of it so that it becomes an item. Now if we are adding, you have to add all the productions of S with a dot in the beginning, right? So the S becomes AA, and since there is a dot to the left of A, you have to add all productions of A with a dot in the beginning, isn't it? So AA, then A gives B, isn't it? See, now for augmented production the look ahead is always dollar symbol, keep that in mind. Now for this production, how do you find out the look ahead symbol is that, see, this production has been added because of the dot in front of this particular S, isn't it? So the first of whatever is remaining after this S is its look ahead. So whatever is remaining after this S is dollar. So first of dollar is the look ahead here. Okay. Now this production has been added because of the dot to the left of this A, isn't it? So whatever is remaining after it, the first of it is the look ahead here. So first of whatever is remaining after A is this capital A. So first of A is AOB. So AOB is the look ahead here. Same with this production. So this is how we find out the look ahead. When we do examples, it will be more clear to you. So we will find out, we will do the construction of LALR and CLR passing tables. We will construct LALR passing table first and will convert that into CLR passing table. It's very easy to do that. So the grammar that we are taking as S gives AA, A gives AA, or A, the very same grammar that we have used to implement SLR passing tables, construct SLR passing table. So I'm writing the augmented grammar, S dash gives S, then S gives AA, now A gives AA or B. So this is the augmented grammar. Now we will start with the construction of passing table. For that we will create the item set, okay, with LR1 items. So the initial set is I0 is obtained by writing the augmented grammar with a dot in the beginning, S dash gives dot S, and as I told you earlier, for augmented production the look ahead is dollar. Now you have to get the closure of this, that is how we usually start. So you have to write, since there is a dot to the left of S, you have to add all productions of S with a dot in the beginning. So you have to write S gives AA with a dot in the beginning. Now you have to add all productions of A with a dot in the beginning. Okay, now we have to find out the look aheads. See, this A dot A, we got this dot AA because of this dot in front of this S. So whatever is remaining after this S, first of that is the look ahead here. So after this S, what you can see is dollar. So first of dollar is dollar itself. So dollar is the look ahead symbol here. Now this production has been added because of the dot in front of this capital A. So whatever is following after this A is this A and dollar. So first of A is the look ahead here. First of A is AOB. So that is the look ahead here. Again, this production has been added because of the dot to the left of this A. So first of whatever is remaining after this A is the look ahead here. So first of A is AOB. So AOB, this is the look ahead here. So this is the item set I0. Okay. Now the only difference between LALR and SLR is this, in this finding out this look ahead and doing them. So in everything else is same. Now you have to take go to I0 comma capital S. You will get S dash gives S dot. When you apply go to, the look ahead doesn't change. So the look ahead is dollar here. Okay. Now since there is no non-terminal with the dot to its left, you can't add anything more to the closure. So that is the closure of this. I'm giving the name I1. Now we can apply go to I0 comma capital A, because there is a dot to the left of A and we can change it to the right of A. So we will get S gives A dot A and the look ahead doesn't change, as I told you. Now there is a dot to the left of A, so you have to add all predictions of A with the dot in the beginning to the closure. Now these two predictions were added because of the dot in front of this A. So first of whatever is remaining after this A is the look ahead here. So what is remaining after this A is dollar. So first of dollar is dollar itself. So this is the look ahead symbols here. So this is the item set I2. Now there is a dot to the left of small a, so you can do go to I0 comma small a. So you will get A gives, the dot will be shifted to the right of A dot A, and the look ahead doesn't change AOB. Now since there is a dot to the left of this A, we have to add all predictions of A with a dot in the beginning. So A gives dot B. Now you have to add the look ahead. This look ahead has been, I mean, this predictions were added because of this dot in front of this A. So first of whatever is remaining after this A will be the look ahead here. So whatever is remaining after this A is AOB. First of AOB is AOB. Okay, so that is the item set here, and this is I3. Now you have I4, go to I0 comma small b. See, when you shift the dot to the right of B, you will get A gives B dot and the look ahead doesn't change AOB. Since this is a final item, the dot is to the right extreme, we can't add nothing more to the closure because there are non-terminal with the dot in the beginning, to dot to its left. So this is I4. Now from this set, we can't apply any go to because there is no symbol with the dot to its left. So here we can apply go to. So go to I2 comma capital A. When you do that, you will get S gives A dot. That look ahead doesn't change. Now we can't add anything more to the closure. The reason being, there is no non-terminal with the dot to its left. Now we can apply go to I2 comma small a. When we do that, you will get S gives A dot A. Look ahead doesn't change dollar. Now because of this dot in front of this A, you have to add all predictions of A with the dot in the beginning. So you will get A gives dot AA. A gives dot B. Now this prediction has been added. These two predictions were added because of the dot to the left of this A. So you have whatever is remaining after this, first of whatever is remaining after this A is the look ahead here. So this is dollar, so dollar. So this is dollar, dollar. See, we have the very same set here, but the look aheads are different. It's A over here, it's dollar here. So we can't say that they are same. You have to write this set. So this is I6. Now when you write B, go to I2 comma B, you will get S gives B dot, the look ahead is dollar. Here the same set is here, but the look ahead is different, so you have to write it. So I7. Now again, when you apply this, go to I3 comma capital A, you will get A is AA dot and the look ahead is AOB. We got the, you know, we haven't received that earlier. Yes. Dot AAB. But this is a final attempt because we have nothing more to add to this because there is no non-terminal with a dot to its left. So nothing more to the closure. This is the final search. Now, see if you are moving this dot to the right of A, you will get A gives A dot A. Then the look ahead is AOB. We will get this very same set again, isn't it? So I3 go to I3 comma small a will be the very same set. Now go to of I3 comma B will go to this very same set, isn't it? Go to of I3 comma B will go to this set. Yeah, I3 comma B. The lookahead doesn't change. So now here there is nothing more. Here there is nothing more. This set is over. This is over. So this is the only set we need to continue from. So go to of I6 comma capital A. You will get S gives A dot and dollar is the look ahead. So this is a final item. So nothing more. We will name the set I9. Now on shifting what A go to on small letter A dot, you will get A dot A dot dollar, the very same set itself. So now change. This is go to of I6 comma small a is this very same set, and I6 comma B will be B dot comma dollar. So this will be the set. Go to of I6 comma B will be this set. That is when we apply B, this becomes A gives B dot comma dollar. So no new set from which we need to proceed. So this is the end of this representation. So now we will construct the table. The table is same as that of, almost same as that of SLR. We have to write the state numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 states are here. So again we have the action part and go to part. Action part, as you know, is for the terminals and go to part is for the non-terminals. Non-terminals are S and A. The action part is for the terminals. The terminals are A, B and dollar. So from state 0 on capital S we are going to 1. On capital, on state 0, from state 0 on capital A we are going to 2. Now from 1 we are not going anywhere. From 2 on capital A we are going to 5. On 2 on on small, no, 2 on capital A 5, then small a small b. Then from 3 on capital A, now we will go in order. So from I0 on small a we are going to I3, so S3. On B we are going to I4, so S4. Then from 1 we are not going anywhere. From 2 on capital A we are going to I5. From on small a we are going to I6. On small b we are going to I7. Now those are the three moves. From 2, from 3 on capital A we are going to I8. On small a we are going to itself. On small b we are going to I4. Now that has been processed. On from I5 we are not going anywhere. From I6 on capital A we are going to state 9. Friends, small a we are going to I6 itself. On small b we are going to I7. Now not anywhere from this nova. Yeah, that's it. Now we have to put the reduced moles. So reduced moles, for this it is very same. That is, this is a special item, documented reduction. Just like we have done in SLR, we have to put the reduced move except in under dollar in row 1, as this is the augmented reduction. So ACC under dollar in row 1, because this is the state 1. See, for all other states or having final item, the reduced moves should be placed under the look ahead symbols. You don't have to find out the fall off left hand side and all. You can simply place the reduced moves under the look ahead symbols. Now final item here. So here there is a final item. A gives B roll. This is the production number 1, this is the production 2, and this is the production 3. Once we are done with this representation item sets, we will throw out this augmented grammar. So the production number is A gives B root is production 3. So you have to put R3 under A and B in row 4. Okay. Now no final items here. There is one final item here, that is in the 5th row. The production number is 1, so we have to place R1 under dollar, because dollar is the look ahead symbol there. No final item here. Here there is a final item. S gives B root. Sorry, this is, I'm sorry, this is A gives AA, A gives dot B. Okay. So A gives B root. A gives B root. The production number is 3. We have to put R3 under dollar in 7th row, because this is the 7th state. Now this is again a final item. A gives AA dot. The production number is 2 here. So in row 8, we have to put R2 under A and B. Now this has a final item, state 9, AA dot. Production number is 2, so we have to place R2 under dollar. So this is the LALR passing table. Now we will see how we can convert this LALR passing table into CLR1 passing table, because this table is bit bigger than SLR, isn't it? Because SLR just had 7 states, but it is having 10 states, 0 to 9, 10 states. So we will convert this into CLR passing table by merging states which are having same LR0 item but different look aheads. So if you look at it, you can see that, see, these two states are same, that is I3 and I6 are same. The only difference is in look aheads. I3 and I6 are same, but the difference is in look ahead symbols. The LR0 items are same. Now again, I4 and I7, they are same, only difference is in look aheads. I4 and I7 are same, the only difference is in look aheads. Now IH and I9, yeah, A dot dollar A dot AB. IH and I9 are same, the only difference is in look aheads. So what we can do is, we can, whenever 3 appears, see, for R2, this R2 is a production number. The 6, 7 of the number following S is the state number. These all numbers are state numbers, but the number following, number which is given as the suffix of R, is production number. Do not change them, but all other numbers are state numbers. So whenever you see 3 or 6, write this as 3, 6. So this is a 3, I'm converting this into 3, 6, so that we can merge it easily. This is S6, I'm converting that into 3, 6, S3, 6. Now I'm converting this 3 into 3, 6, this into 3, 6. Now R3 I can't change, because that is not the state number, but that is the production number. The 6 is converted to 3, 6. This 6 is converted to 3, 6. Now, yeah, that's it. Now same with 4, 7. When I'm seeing 4, I'm converting that into 4, 7. This 7 is converted into 4, 7. This is converted into 4, 7. Now this is into 4, 7. This is into 4, 7. This is into 4, 7. Yeah, that's it. Now 8 and 9 together, so I'm writing this 8 9, so this becomes 8 9, this becomes 8 9, and 8 and 9 doesn't appear anywhere else. So we can merge the rows. See, this is a 3 6, this is 8 3 6. I can merge these two rows, S 3 6, S 4 7, S 3 6, S 4 7, 8 9, 8 9. So they are exactly the same when we merge these state numbers. So I can rub the extra one. Okay. Now there are two 4 7s, 4 7, 4 7, R3, R3, but 1 R3 here. So when I merge this, this R3 is shifted here, and this R3, taking union. So this R3 will remain, these two R3s will be merged into one. So this is deleted. Now 8, 9, 8, 9. So see, when I am merging these two 8, 9s, this R2 and R2 appears under A and B. So this contain an R2 and a dollar. So when we merge, that R2 will appear under dollar also. So this is the table after merging. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 states, just like the SLR. We got a table with just the 7 states. So this is how we convert LILR passing table into CLR passing table. As the number of rows containing empty cells increases, the error detecting capability will increase. So LILR is said to have very high error detecting capability, but the disadvantage is the passing table is pretty huge. That can be rectified using this method, by converting that into CLR.